Good morning, everyone. Welcome to our English service, English Saturday program. I thank you all for being here. I'm pretty sure that I'm speaking for both Elizabeth and I whenever I say that it is an honor to be able to bring you this program. Now, we'll be opening the program in prayer. We ask our pastor, Brian Garcia, please open this program in prayer.
Amen. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we are gathered here this afternoon, grateful for this beautiful Sabbath that you have given us to be able to share your word with one another, to be able to delight in the songs that are going to be brought forth. I ask you, Lord, that you receive the honor and glory from all of this, and that you use Elizabeth and Ever during this program, that your Holy Spirit guide them, and that you also use Lisa in the message, that we may be edified, that we may be strengthened, Lord, and that your name may be glorified. All of this I ask in Jesus' name. Amen.
Well, now we're going to follow up in having a hymn, and we ask all the congregation to sing along with us. We're going to sing the hymn, Since Jesus Came Into My Heart, and we ask everybody at home to please sing along with us this hymn. Amen. We're going to read a scripture that is found in Deuteronomy chapter 7, verse 9, that goes, Know therefore that the Lord your God is God. He is a faithful God, keeping his covenant of love to the thousand generation of those who love him and keep his commandments. Amen. Everyone wants to be cherished, but more than often, human devotion isn't always dependable. Even the most stable of relationships change over time, and unlike our love, God's love is unwavering and perfect in all aspects. It never changes, it never fails, and it never gives up. Now we see in 1 John chapter 4, verse 7 through 8. Dear friends, let us love one another, for love comes from God. Everyone who loves has been born of God and knows God. Whoever does not love does not know God, because God is love. Amen. Now, God's love is intrinsic to his nature. It means it's part of him. 1 John tells us God is the source of love. It also reveals that love is not only one of the Creator's fundamental character traits. He is love, his very being. When we think about God, one of our main focuses is that he is loving. We don't picture God to be unkind or indifferent. Joel chapter 2, verse 13 reminds us, and rent your heart and not your garments, and turn unto the Lord your God, for he is gracious and merciful, slow to anger, and of great kindness, and repenteth him of the evil. Amen. God is very patient with us, contrary to the world's mindset. In fact, God is love does not mean that he winks or excuses sin. However, he will forgive you if you are humble enough to come and ask him, because he loves us.
Amen. And now we're going to ask our pastor, Brian Garcia, to have the announcements.
Amen. Good morning or good afternoon, brothers and sisters. We have a couple of announcements for you today. First of all, it's a very foggy day here in Fort Worth. You can't even see the sky because the fog is very dense. But we know above all that, the sun is shining. And just the same way sometimes we don't understand, we can't see the Lord, or we're going through a gloomy time in our lives. But the Lord is shining and waiting for those clouds to break or to open so we can see him working in our lives. We have this past week been in meetings. The leadership of the church has been in meetings. There's lots of changes, lots of things going on, so stay tuned. We will be communicating some things later on about how this may impact our church locally, and but all of these things would be so that the church can grow and progress and be more healthy. So God willing, we will be working together so that his name will be glorified. We're having our weekly English service every Saturday at 1 p.m. And we invite you all to go on your social media and share the Facebook link and share the word with your friends, put it on your WhatsApp channels so that more people can join and be edified. We're grateful that we have a good participation today. Let's see how many people.
Thank you, Brian, for those announcements. Now we're going to have the hymn for the offering, Lord, I Lift Your Name on High. Amen. Brian has a few more things to add, so if you would like to continue, go ahead.
Thank you. Thank you, Elizabeth. Yeah, sorry, guys. I guess my microphone went on mute. I didn't notice. I was just rambling on. And anyways, I'm not sure at what point I got cut off, but I was saying we're having our regular Saturday services at 1 p.m. And share it with all your friends. Tomorrow, we will not be having the English service at 10 a.m. So just wanted to call that out. We will be having an in-person service in our church at 11:30, but it'll be in Spanish. Next week, the following week, I think it's March 5th, we will be having the Sunday service in English, in person. So we'll be broadcasting it through YouTube, so stay tuned for that as well. That is all I have. May the Lord bless you all.
Amen. Thank you. Now we're going to ask our sister Lainey Rodriguez to have the prayer for the offering.
Amen. Dear Lord, thank you so much for your goodness. Thank you so much for your presence with us, Lord, for letting us be able to gather virtually and praise your name, to be able to know this wonderful truth that you have an unwavering love for us, that you care for us so deeply, Lord, that you gave your only son to die for us so that we could be renewed by you and be able to have this relationship with you. Help us always be grateful and walk even closer with you daily, Father. I ask you that you bless those who chose to give to your church. I ask you that you help us to be able to give with an open hand, with an open heart, knowing that everything that we have comes from you, Lord God. Every good gift is from you. I ask you that you would continue to work in your church, that you would continue to edify us and lift us up and lift up the church internationally as well, so that we can continue to spread your love, to spread the good news of your son, Jesus, Father, and the salvation that you gave us and that you give us. I ask you that you guide us closer to you in every moment. I ask you all in the name of Jesus, amen.
Amen. Beautiful prayer. We're going to keep talking about God's love in this afternoon. And I did forget to mention that the title of this program is Unwavering Love, because God's love is not changing. And it's just so immense. We're going to go on and read Luke chapter 7, verse 34. And so says the word of God. The Son of Man came eating and drinking, and you say, here is a glutton and a drunkard, a friend of tax collectors and sinners. Amen. And we're going to explain this. So God's love is, like we all know, it's universal. He has compassion for both the believers and the unbelievers. And while Jesus was on earth, he perfectly illustrated the nature of the Father's nature and character. One surprising fact is that he befriended tax collectors and sinners. These two groups of people were despised and avoided by the godly Jews of Jesus' day. Why? Well, tax collectors would often exploit their fellow countrymen by requiring more payment than was actually due to Rome. And sinners were those who scoffed at God's law and failed to participate in the temple rituals and made money by other sinful means. Jesus didn't just preach to these people. He actually enjoyed their company, and they enjoyed his. Another example is found in John 3:16, which we all know. And what motivated God to send Jesus to earth? Well, he loved those who knew him, and even those who still did not. Jesus knew that he would be dying for those who hated him, yet he did it willingly because he loved us.
Amen. And I would like to read Romans 8:37-39. So says the word of God. No, in all things, these we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. For I am convinced that neither death nor life, neither angels nor demons, neither the present nor the future, nor any powers, neither height nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God that is in Jesus Christ our Lord. Nothing can separate us from the love of God. No matter what happens, his love will never let go of us. Even the tax collectors that Ever just mentioned, they were considered to be among the worst people. They were still inseparable from the love of Jesus. And Jesus, being without sin, would eat and enjoy their company, stubbornly searching them out. The same thing goes for us. We can fail and fall away from him, yet he still loves us and is constantly searching for us. We're going to have a special hymn titled Stubborn Love by our sister from Dallas, Itamar Guzman.
again. Your faithless friend, don't you ever tire of hearing what a fool I've been. Guess I should pray, but what can I say? Oh, it hurts to know the 100 times I've caused you pain. Though forgive me sounds so empty when I never change, yet you stay and say I love you still, for giving me time and time again. And your stubborn love that never lets go of me, I don't understand how you can say perfect love. Just couldn't see, even long before I knew you, you were loving me. Sometimes I cry, you must cry too, when you see the broken promises I've made to you. I keep saying that I'll trust you, though I seldom do. Yet you stay and say you love me still, knowing someday I'll be like you. And your stubborn love, it never lets go of me. I don't understand how you can say love, embracing the worst in me. How I long for you,
Amen. What a beautiful song. It says, I don't understand how you can stay. Perfect love, embracing the worst of me. How I long for your stubborn love. Once again, it tells us that God's love is never going to give up on us. Through the good and the bad, he will be by our side. A lot of us dream to find the kind of love that never changes. But what we sometimes don't realize is that we already have that love in Jesus Christ.
Amen. I don't know if Alex is out there, but I have a quote from C.S. Lewis that I really found to be, impactful. And it goes like this. The Christian does not think God will love us because we are good, but that God will make us good because he loves us. And now also like the hymn, Stubborn Love, which mentions that even though we make promises that we break constantly and we fail to keep them, our own word God still loves us. God knows that we will be able to one day live in holiness, and that we will obey him and love him with all our hearts, and with all our souls, and with all our mind. This is why he never gives up on us. And we're going to go on to read another scripture. This one is found in Romans chapter 5, verse 8. And so says the word of God. But God demonstrates his own love for us in this. While we were still sinners, Christ died for us. And what else can I say? God's love is unconditional. Unlike earthly affection, his love does not fluctuate. It does not change. Many of us believe that sinning or ignoring God will change how his love for us, but in reality, his eternal and immense love persists. He doesn't love us more when we have pleased him, or any less when we have sinned. Even after a period of spiritual dryness, we can have complete confidence that God will welcome us back with open arms. His love never gives up. And like this next hymn will say, it says, and when he saw in full just how much his love would cost, he still went the final mile between me and heaven so that I would not be lost. And were it not for Jesus' unconditional love, that seeing us in the midst of our wicked ways, came down and offered grace so that we would not be lost. Our brother Armando Juarez Jr. with the next hymn titled, Were It Not For Grace.
Were it not some pointless road to nowhere, with my salvation up to me. I know how that would go. The battles I would face. But losing the race, were it not for grace. Forever running, but losing the race, were it not for grace. God.
Amen. I would like to read John 15:12-13. So says the word of God. My command is this: love each other as I have loved you. Greater love has no one than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. God's love is sacrificial. Jesus surrendered his life on the cross so that we might have eternal life and enjoy fellowship with God while we are still living on earth. Jesus' motivation for love was mankind. Just like the song says, if it weren't for God's grace and his abundant love, we would be lost. His sacrifice has made it possible for us to one day live eternally with him.
Amen. And that love is just beautiful. I mean, every day I think about it, I thought about it while I was writing this program, and it's just, his love is just so great and immense. If we actually take the time and you try to think of his love, you really can. I get overflowed, like, with thoughts, like I really can't take his love and measure it. The other day I was watching a movie and where it showed where Jesus was being crucified, and so many times in the movie, I know it was a movie and everything, but I wanted to be there and I wanted to take the hits for him so many times, and he kept walking, and I wasn't even born back then, and yet he died all the way 2,000 years ago. He died for me, and that's just amazing love. And throughout the entirety of this program, we've been talking about God's love for us. And around these 30 minutes of this program, we still haven't been able to reach the tip of the iceberg of his immense love. His love is mighty and powerful. It's like a hurricane, and we're but a tree that bends beneath his mercy. And like this next song says, and it perfectly describes his grace, that we are drawn to redemption by the grace in his eyes. And if his grace was an ocean, we'd all be sinking in it. That's just beautiful, brothers and sisters. We will now continue to a moment of worship, and we ask the congregation to please join along with us and praise his name and sing about his love for us.
He is jealous for me, loves like a hurricane. I am a tree bending beneath the weight of his wind and mercy. When all of a sudden I am unaware of these afflictions eclipsed by glory, and I realize just how beautiful you are and how great your affections are for me. And oh, how he loves us. Oh, oh, how he loves us. How he loves us all. Oh. Like a hurricane, I am a tree bending beneath the weight of his wind and mercy. When all of a sudden I'm unaware of these afflictions eclipsed by glory, and I realize just how beautiful you are and how great your affections are for.
Amen. Now we're going to have the reading of the scripture for the message, which is found in John 6:47. So says the word of God. Most assuredly, I say to you, he who believes in me has everlasting life. Amen. We're going to ask our brother Alex Rodriguez to have the prayer for the message.
Father, we come before you in this moment and we give you thanks for the opportunity you've given us to be able to praise and worship your holy name, for all the mercies, for the abundant love that you have shown us, Father God, because you sustain us, because you give us life and health and wellness, Father God, but more importantly, because you give us faith that you allow us to maintain our eyes on you, Father God. We ask that you continue to speak to our hearts, that you may be with us, that in the portion of the sermon, we may hear from you, Father God, that we may know that you are with us, that you are still working on us, that even if we are going through trials and tribulations, that your comfort and love still surround us, Father God. Be with us and speak to our hearts, Lord. Make our hearts willing to listen and to take in your word, Father God, and that in everything you may be glorified. All these things we ask in Jesus' name, amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever. Amen.
Amen. Now we pass it on to our sister Lisa Hernandez with the message that saves.
Amen. May my first words be to glorify the name of the Lord for the opportunity and the responsibility to bring a message to you, his people, that he has given me. I want to congratulate Ever and Elizabeth for this program. What a beautiful program you guys organized and put together. the Holy Spirit is using our youth in powerful ways during this pandemic. I sincerely believe that, you know, Satan wanted this pandemic to isolate us and to discourage us, but by the grace of God, this pandemic has brought out the workers, and in more ways than we ever thought possible. And so Ever and Elizabeth and the youth who have been directing our services and all of the things that the Holy Spirit has led us to do for the English ministry has been such of a blessing, not only to me, but to others. And so congratulations to our youth who are being used by God. This message is titled, Rest Assured. I had received these words after I had left the room of a COVID-positive patient of mine that had just passed away. And I had been praying with this patient as they took their last breath and as their heart stopped beating. I had felt led to pray with them and to recite scripture to them to bring peace and to bring hope for their future. I know through their family and through talking with the patient before they were placed on a ventilator that they had faith and they trusted God. And so in their last moments, as the nurses and I were in there and life support was being withdrawn, I was praying and I was begging God for mercy and for his grace. And he gave me these words, rest assured. This particular situation with this patient was one of the most difficult for me and for my nurses and for the doctors. This person's spouse had passed away just moments before, and now the last of this married couple was passing away, and that hit home for many reasons. One of them being that this couple wasn't much older than me and Ezekias, so it kind of hit home a little bit more. This couple wasn't the first or even the second married couple to pass away at the same time, but this was the latest one that we had. And I was in my head and I was praying and I was lamentating, and we're so tired of this war against COVID. We're so tired of the death. We're so tired of all of the hurt and the pain. We're just tired and we need rest. So I was praying for my nurses who were in tears. I was praying for the doctors who were coming by. I was praying for everybody involved in this situation. And these are the words that the Holy Spirit used to bring comfort to me. And it was more of a comfort that I could ever express with my words. We can rest assured that for those who believe in Jesus Christ, we have a future in heaven. We will have everlasting life. The promise of a body that is not worn, that is not sick, that is not tired, that is not weary. The promise of emotional rest, that we will not have sorrow in heaven. We will not have the emotional pain. We will not have tears. We will not have anxiety. We will not have depression. We have a promised rest in store for us in our future. That's all well and good to forward think and to think of our future. But what about right now? Right now, I am tired and I am weary, just like so many of us find ourselves right here, right now. We are tired. But we can rest assured in the promise that God gave us in Matthew 11, 28 through 30. Come to me, all who are weary and burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart. You will find rest for your soul, for my yoke is easy and my burden is light. We can rest assured that when we are weary, when we are tired, our flesh is sick and we have no strength, He will be our strength. In Psalm 73, verse 26 says, "My flesh and my heart may fail, but God is the strength of my heart and my portion forever." My brothers and sisters, our body may fail, but God is our strength. We can rest assured that our Heavenly Father does not grow weary. Isaiah chapter 40, verses 28 through 31 says, "Do you not know? Have you not heard? The Lord is the everlasting God, the creator of the ends of the earth. He will not grow tired or weary, and his understanding no one can fathom. He gives strength to the weary and increases the power of the weak. Even the youths grow tired and weary, and the young man stumble and fall. But those who hope in the Lord will renew their strength. They will soar on the wings like eagles. They will run and not grow weary. They will walk and not faint." He understands our weakness. He understands our tiredness. He understands our struggle. His understanding is unsearchable. He knows our comings and our goings, and we can rest assured that He sees and He understands what we are going through. We may feel isolated and we may feel alone. We may feel like we're in the trenches in the middle of the war, but rest assured, my brothers and my sisters, that God is there with you and He understands. Not only does He understand, but He will give the weak power and He will give strength to the weary. My brothers and sisters, we can rest assured that He will supply all of our needs. When we are worried about our finances, when we are worried about food, when we are worried about our electricity, when we are worried about our provision, we know from Philippians 4:19, it says, "And my God shall supply all of your needs according to His riches and glory by Christ Jesus." We know that all of our needs will be met according to what God has in store for us. God's picture for our future may look a little bit different than ours. So according to His riches and glory, according to His ideal and His perfect will, He shall supply all of your needs. We can rest assured that we can be victorious over our sin struggle. 1 Peter 2:24 says, "Who Himself bore our sins in His own body on the tree, that we, having died to sin, might live for righteousness, by whose stripes you are healed." My brothers and sisters, whatever sin struggle you are dealing with, whether you're dealing with it in secret or openly, we know that Jesus Himself carried our sins on His body so that we can live in righteousness. By His wounds, we can be healed. Your sin struggle is not too great for God. You are weary carrying the weight of your sin. You are tired of the struggle and you are burdened. But take your burden to the cross. Confess it to your Heavenly Father and receive the forgiveness that He is so ever lovingly wanting to give you. Your sin struggle is not too much for him. It's not too dirty. It's not too great. It's not too small. He is willing to extend forgiveness and salvation to you. John 16:33. These things I have spoken to you, that in me you may have peace. In the world you will have tribulation, but be of good cheer. I have overcome the world. Jesus overcame the world. He conquered death. He had victory over the enemy. You can claim victory over your sin struggle in the name of Jesus. My brothers and sisters, rest assured that we have these promises firm and secure because our hope is in him, and he is firm and secure. He does not waver. He does not move. He is truly our anchor, and he is our peace, our rest, our comfort. So in his promises, my brothers and sisters, we can rest assured. May God bless you.
Amen. What a beautiful message. We can rest assured in God. And now we ask our sister Lisa to have the closing prayer.
Amen. Let us pray. My Heavenly Father, I thank you and I praise you for the Sabbath service that you have given us. I thank you for the direction of the service. I thank you for the message that you so lovingly gave us and the reminder that we can rest assured in your promises because your promises are true. Father, I ask that you will be with each and every one of us as we go throughout our week. Help us to look to you as our anchor of our hope, our anchor so firm and secure. And now we ask that the blessed love of God, the grace and peace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the companion and communion of the Holy Spirit, our great counselor, be with all of his children, now and forever. Amen.
Amen. Thank you everyone for coming to our Saturday service. We thank everybody for coming. Thank you.